Hello, I'm Nicki Shields, and welcome to Select Electric's Guide to Electric Vehicle Charging. Now, here I'm going to explain how to charge your electric car at home, and then what to do when you're out and about during the day. And finally, we'll talk about how to rapid charge your car on those longer journeys. So let's get started. Now, if you're one of the lucky ones to have off-street parking, then you're going to do most of your charging at home. Although you can charge your EV from a standard 3-pin socket, it's faster and safer to use a dedicated charging point. They either come with a cable and plug permanently attached, and these are known as tethered chargers, or without a cable and plug, just the socket, and these are called untethered sockets or universal chargers. So which type is best? Well, if you have a tethered charger, it means you don't need to get your charging cable out of the boot every time you want to top up, which is quite handy if it's raining. However, on the other hand, an untethered universal charger, it looks a bit tidier and it's more discreet on your wall. There isn't really a right or a wrong answer to this. The choice is very much up to you. So you see this? It's called a Type 2 plug. Most modern electric vehicles in the UK take a Type 2 plug for home charging. It fits into your car's socket just like this. Some EVs still take a Type 1 plug, so double check before you order your charging point. Now, as electricity is much cheaper than petrol and diesel, pure electric vehicles, called battery electric vehicles, also known as BEVs, can reduce your monthly car running costs by a substantial amount. To achieve these savings, you need to charge your car on a cheap electricity tariff. You can program your vehicle or even the charging point itself to start charging when the cheap tariff actually kicks in. There are also apps available that can automate the whole process, so you can set it up once and then forget about it. So how long does charging take? Well, it depends, of course, on how empty or full your battery is. But for the average EV, you can get about 25 to 30 miles of range into your car after about an hour of charging using a typical 7.4 kilowatt home charging point. Now, most people charge up overnight and wake up to a nice full tank of electricity. Charging points are popping up at more and more convenient locations such as supermarkets, shopping centres, restaurants, gyms, hotels and B&Bs. And most of these public chargers will be untethered Type 2 chargers, so you mustn't forget to bring your charging cable with you. Generally, they charge at the same speed as a home charger. Public chargers like these are sometimes free to use. It can just be a case of buying some groceries or dining there, and then it's free to charge up. But for others, you do have to pay, and you will very quickly work out your favourite locations for a top-up. If you're going on a long trip in a fully electric car, you will need to stop and charge when your battery is running low. Now, to get electricity into your car quickly, you're going to want to use a rapid charger. These are normally located at service stations along your route. Rapid chargers typically come with either two or three different plugs attached. Depending on the make and model of your car, you will either use the CCS plug for rapid charging, the CHAdeMO plug, or a Type 2 plug. Now, unlike the slower charging points at the supermarkets and shops, you nearly always have to pay for a rapid charging point. Many chargers now offer contactless payment, others requires downloading of an app, and some a subscription. Be warned, it's a bit of a minefield, so it does require some planning. After between roughly 20 and 50 minutes of charging, plenty of time to grab yourself a coffee, your battery will normally be sufficiently charged to continue your journey. So, top tip, if you do decide that you want a fully electric car, a BEV, check its maximum DC charging speed in kilowatts. For example, a car with 100 kilowatt rapid charging capabilities can refill its battery twice as fast as a car rated at 50 kilowatts, assuming that you're using one of the newer 150 kilowatt charging stations. Finally, if you're a plug-in hybrid PHEV driver with both a battery and internal combustion engine, well, generally rapid DC charging isn't an option as most PHEVs don't have a rapid charging socket. There are exceptions though, and newer PHEV models are adding rapid charging, so it is important to check the specs before you lease. In summary then, the key points about charging your EV are: at home, if you have off-street parking, get a dedicated charging point installed and make sure you charge on a low-cost tariff. If you need to charge when you're out during the day, make sure you take your charging cable with you and get a quick boost while you're shopping, eating, or at the gym. And then for those longer trips, you'll want to plan ahead to find out where you should stop to rapid charge your car. Please get in touch with the Select Electric team if you do have any questions about charging or leasing a car in general, and I'll see you soon.